Each one has got their own reason, their own desire. Each one has got their own desire, of course. It may be enlightenment, or the energy, or the experience, to have the same experience again. You see, you had some dreams, some change, transformation in your life, to have little more transformation, or some desire. Desire, that is what makes you work. That is what makes you do things. We are going to work on that subject, desire. That is what makes this mental body alive. Of course, we have a very wrong concept about desire. The very word desire you condemn, because you are taught from the very young age that you should control your desires. You should suppress your desires. Can you be alive without desires? You can't even breathe without desire. You know, the very breathing happens only with desire. You can't even breathe without desire. Only thing, there are two things: the unconscious desire and conscious desire. The unconscious desire means never it gets fulfilled, and it always just erupts in your mind. Neither you know the way to fulfill it, nor it guides you to fulfill itself. It is there, but cannot guide you to fulfill that desire. It never gets fulfilled. But the conscious desires, it just helps you to fulfill itself. By fulfilling that desire, you feel the fulfillment. Conscious desire means the desire, by its own power, it shows you the way to fulfill it. It gives you the clear map to reach it. When you reach that desire also gets fulfilled, and you also get fulfilled. Unconscious desire, you do not even know the way in which you have to proceed towards the desire. And not only that, because that is not getting fulfilled, it never allows you to feel the fulfillment. These are the two layers of desires. If your desires are brought from unconscious to consciousness, when they are brought, they are just flooded with energy. So two things happen. Either they get fulfilled, they show themselves, they show the way to fulfill, you fulfill it, or they just disappear. If they can't be fulfilled, they just disappear. They are not hanging in your mind like a hangover. They don't just stay in your mind and disturb your life. Well, if you understand, because it's a very simple concept. Of course, any other question on this concept, and I will answer.
Swami, what is an unconscious desire? What?
The quality of the unconscious desire is you yourself not aware that you want it. See, conscious desire means what you want to have in your life. Unconscious desire means just because somebody else is having, you want to have that. You see he is having, then immediately you think, oh, let me have that also. Let me have that, it will be so nice. Then it is just unconscious. You do not know the way to reach it. It never gets fulfilled, but it is there just as a hangover. That is the thing which is called unconscious desire. Desire which comes by seeing others' life, not as your own, not as your own desire.
Can you expand on sealing on desires? Sealing on desire. Is said we suppress our desires, but it is have a ceiling on the desires. That's what it's
one thing. Even the ceiling is suppression. Even the ceiling is a suppression. So these desires, they should never, no desire should be suppressed. You should bring the desire to the light of consciousness. So the light of consciousness, either it will fulfill it or dissolve it. Whenever you are aware, conscious, you never get foolish desires. Do you get the desire to fly? You never. You never. You know, either you can fly by aircrafts or through some flight or the way, or you have to forget that desire. So whenever it is brought to the consciousness, whenever it comes to the conscious level, you will see just the disappear. Now, we will bring the desires to the conscious level. Of course, this technique I am explaining to you logically. Next session onwards, you will be given only the technique and you will see the result. No logical explanation. Because whenever you get the logical explanation, your mind starts working before the technique works. In Tamil, there is a proverb. Adrishtam raila varadamudi daradara dandila vandirukkunna. The fortune is coming by train, but the unfortunate is coming already by the telegram. Mind is actually, logic is unfortunate. Before the fortune of energy reaches you by train, the unfortunate of the mind reaches you by the telegram. So I don't want you to reach the, don't want any mind to reach before the energy reaches you. So next session onwards, you will be directly given the technique, you will continue to practice, then you will see the result. I don't want you to have a prejudice or the pre-understanding about the technique, about the layers. Then you will start having your own concepts.